Okay, so just observe how our security configuration is made in OBIEE, like how each user, application role or group is configured in OBIEE. Before starting with security configuration, let me show you where security is implemented in OBIEE, in which place, and just we will observe different roles that are present. Okay, so to get a basic idea of how security really works. So for this, I have to open my EM and console both. Okay, so first open my console with WebLogic Welcome One. And open EM as well. Okay, so here in console, just observe there is a tab called Security Realms. Click on that. Under Security Realms, there is something called My Realm. Click on My Realm. And here you have something called as Users and Groups. So click on Users and Groups. You will be able to see all the users and groups that are present in this application. As of now, these are users. There are only 7 users, and this is displaying all the 7 users as of now. So what I will do for our practice, I will delete these 2 users because these users are created by our own. Okay, so let me delete these users. And groups also I'll delete. I have created 3 groups: sales associate, sales manager, and sales supervisor groups. Okay, so you can observe. Sales managers group. And this one also. Sales supervisors group also. And you can just see other membership. Just let me show you from the beginning how to create it and how to do that, so you will be much more comfortable. Okay, and in Enterprise Manager, just configuring a user and group will not satisfy your security constraint. Okay, everything will work based on the application role in your OBIEE, not on the group or not just user. User is very important, but group is logical grouping of your users. This is just a logical grouping. You will never know where you will set a permission for your group. Okay, everything is based on your application role. So if you are creating something called sales associate group, you will be creating something called as sales associate application role as well. Okay, and you define permissions for your application role, not for a group. Now click on Business Intelligence, right click on Core Application, there is something called Security. Click on Application Roles. So this will list out all the application roles that are present here. So you can see Sales Associate role, Sales Manager role, and Sales Supervisor role, everything. Okay, so let me delete all this. Generally, don't delete anything in your real time because they will your managers will not leave you, then they will be behind you. You should not delete. This is for practice, so I am showing you how to do it. Yeah. So by default, your OBIE comes with this, whatever groups you see, this will be present, and whatever the application roles, only this will be present when you install your application. One is BI system user. The application role will contain one user who is responsible. The user is responsible for communicating for inter-component communication, like your presentation server and your Oracle BI server component are communicating. When you click on availability restart all, they are communicating, right? So there should be a security mechanism which can handle this, which can communicate between both the components and which should get the requested result. So this BI system user is the user or the application role which contains a user, and this will be the component behind all your inter-process communication. And these three are for your RPD object security or your UI security. By default, all the users will be like authenticated users. And if you give BI consumer role, what they can see, anything which is created in shared folders, your BI consumer can see. And if you want to create any report or any dashboard, you should have a BI author role. BI consumer role cannot create anything. He can only view. He will have only read access. Whereas BI author role will have create access, create report, create dashboard, anything. And BI administrator role, like your WebLogic user is there right now, right? So if he is a BI administrator role user, then you can see all corresponding administration links, manage sessions, manage permissions, cache purging, everything. This is like a master role. We will not give to everyone. Only two or three people who are administrators of OBAWE, only for them we will give BI administrator. Other than that, even all the developers will be BI authors. And by default, all the users will be BI consumers. Okay. And you can even observe in our users, check WebLogic user, to which group he belongs. Does he belongs to BI administrators group? And just check, your BI administrator is there, right? And I gave WebLogic user explicitly, as well as BI administrators group also. So any user who is part of this BI administrators group will have this BI administrator application role. That means if anyone want to have this application role privileges, they should be a member of this group, or we can add the users explicitly. Adding the user explicitly, suppose say if you have 50 users for BI author, so is it intelligent enough to add all the 50 under membership? No. Yeah. So the best way is, see here, in BI author also I am giving BI administrator also. That means whatever BI author is getting, your BI administrator gets. And here you can see whatever BI consumer has, your BI author gets. And whatever BI author has, your BI administrator gets. So BI administrator is again member of BI author also. Right? And by default, BI authors group will be added. So whoever is part of BI authors, by default, that group will come. And all the users who are BI authors will be able to see these roles. And don't confuse between roles and groups. You can ask me, if a particular user is part of BI author group, he will have all the permissions with respect to BI author application role. That's it. And whatever BI author application role has permissions, if any user is present under BI administrator group, all that users again will get this BI author permissions also. Don't get confused here, okay? Fine. So now in this, yeah, so each role, I said already, right? BI consumer is like by default read permission for all the shared folder objects, not my folder objects. My folder objects are with you have in OBI, you have my folders and shared folders, two folders you'll have in catalog. Anything you saved in my folders is private to you. Anything you do it in shared folders is to public and to everyone. So by default, BI consumer can see that whatever is created in shared folder. BI author can create something. BI consumer will not have any create privilege. He can create a dashboard or he can create a report and save it. And BI administrator is the administrator user. Okay? Yeah. So in this exercise today, let us see how to create users, how to create groups, how to create application roles, and how to assign permissions and just login. Fine. For that purpose, what I have two users now. So before that, what we are doing? So let me create groups first. One is sales manager group, sales supervisor group, and sales associate group. So let me create. Sales associate group first. So how to do that? Go to groups, create a new group, click on new, I am creating a group. Group is just logical representation of all your users. Give the name and give the description as sales associates group. Okay. Provide this default authenticator as of now. Click OK. And just see your sales associate group. I am not giving any membership. Okay. I will explain you about this. Create one more group called as sales supervisors group. And create one more group called as sales manager group. Right? And for sales, see what I want to have. Each associate, your sales manager should get all the privileges which are got by even your sales associates also. So whatever is given for your sales associate, that permission should come from your sales supervisor as well as sales manager also. So what I will do for sales manager group, I will take sales associate as the member. So any employee who is part of the sales associate group, right? Or you can say who will get the sales associate permission, you will be having, sales manager will be having all the permissions that are given to your sales associate group also. Okay. So just click on save and go back to your sales supervisor group and do the same thing. So, whereas in application roles, we will give it in a reverse way. We will give sales associate role, there we will give sales associate group, as well as we will give sales manager role and sales application role also part of that. Because all the permissions which are given to sales associate role should go there. But here, I am giving membership. This group can be member of any parent group. So, your sales associates are part of your sales supervisors or sales managers. Like this. Okay. This is still okay. Okay. So no issues. So you can go through this description and all. Okay. So create group hierarchy. This means any privilege or permission assigned to sales associate group will be inherited by your sales supervisor group. So if you are assigning for sales associate group, what you are assigning? Sales associate application role. So whatever permissions you are assigning for your sales associate group will be inherited by your parent groups. What are parent groups? Your manager role as well as this one also. Otherwise, you can even give explicitly go to application role, give sales manager role and sales application role, even then it comes. Right? So anything is okay. Now create two users, Joe's Cruz and Alan Ziff. So, create a new user as Joe's Cruz. Give the description as Joe's Cruz. Give the provider password. Give the user password as Joe's Cruz one. It is up to you. You can give any password. Okay. See, I am just creating a user. Keep in mind that I am not associating it with any group or anything. Okay. I can give groups here later. Okay. But fine. Create one more user. Alan Ziff. Password as Alan Ziff one and Alan Ziff one.
This is also our default authenticator.
Yeah, everything is provided by your default authenticator. I am not adding any LDAP server or anything like that. Okay, so everything is by default. Whatever is OBI giving you, with the same thing you are using it. Okay, so now what I am doing for Alan Ziff, I am associating him to BI author and sales associate group. So for AlanZip, how to do that? Go to AlanZip user. So you already created groups. So click on groups, make him BA author as well as sales associate. So he belongs to, user belongs to two groups, sales associate group and BA author group. Just save this. And for Joe Cruz, this user belongs to BA author, sales manager and sales supervisor group. BA authors, sales manager and sales supervisor, both. Right? Next job is, as soon as you create groups, next job is to create application rules. Just creating groups will not solve your purpose. Without assigning to your application roles, there is no meaning for your group and user. So what to, how to do that? Go here, click on create, give the role name, as sales associate role, or click for sales manager role, anything is fine. Okay. So for sales manager's role, add your sales manager group. How to get that group? Type as group. Just click on this. There are, it will give you all the list of groups available. From here, all the employees who are part of your sales manager group should have this application role. Okay, I am giving this application role and members will be. So any person who is part of the sales manager group. Now, in my list, who is the Joe Cruz? Joe Cruz is a member of sales manager group. So he will have all the permissions which are given to your role. You can control all the permissions with respect to our role. Okay, just click OK. Create one more role as sales supervisor's role and give it as group. Just give and go for here. Give sales supervisor group within this. Click OK. One more is sales associate role also I am creating. Add your sales associate group. And I am adding my application roles as sales manager role as well as sales supervisor role also for this. Why I am doing this? Because okay, so sales manager role and sales supervisor role will get all the permissions that are given to your sales associate role. Okay, these will inherit the same thing, the meaning we gave it in console also. In group, we gave sales associate group as the member. So sales associate group is the member of your sales manager group. So whatever sales associate group is getting, these permissions will be inherited by sales manager role and sales supervisor. But explicitly, I am here defining again that my sales manager role and sales supervisor role should get all the permissions which are given to my sales associate role. So now who is the sales associate? I created two users. AlanZip is the sales associate. You will get all the permissions with respect to sales associate. And what does this Joe Cruz will have? Whatever is given to AlanZip, even that also will be there. And he will have additional permissions also. Okay. Click on OK. Now everything is done. Now just log into your application with respect to your users created newly. So log in with Joe Cruz. So it is logged in and just go for my account. Check the roles and catalog groups that he belongs. So he belongs to sales manager role, sales supervisor role, and he will get all the permissions that are assigned to sales associate role. So he will get all the three roles. And I gave him BA authors group. So BA author group means whatever is given to BA author role and BA consumer role, everything you should get. Okay. So like this, you will be able to see all the roles that he belongs. similar way, just sign out of this. Sign in with AlanZip. AlanZip one. In document it is there. Okay. Check his application roles. So he will be sales associate role as well as BA consumer. Yeah, BA consumer and sales associate. Yeah, I gave him BA author. Yeah, BA author, BA consumer, sales associate. All the three will come. Now, you created application roles, you created groups, you are able to log in and everything is fine. Now, setting up object permissions, we will see in RPD. Okay, now, this is RPD object level security. So, you have subject areas, you have tables. So, I want to see how to restrict them. Okay. First thing is, in RPD, how to check your identity is, you have to log into your RPD using your online mode. Okay. So, log into your RPD using BI administration tool. And log in using online mode. Provide the repository password. There is something called manage identity. Click on identity. There is something called action set online user filter. Click on this. Give asterisk. That means I want all the users, list of all the users. Just click, as soon as you click OK, you can see that all the users are present. From your 7 users are there. Here you can see 7. Whatever is there in your console under users and groups. Everything you will see under manage identity in RPD. This will happen only in online mode. Okay. And check in application roles. This will have all the application roles that you have created in your enterprise manager. You have by default BA system, administrator, author and consumer. And I created 3 roles and you can see all the 3 roles. Okay. Like this. Fine. Good. Next job is set permissions for a repository object. So for a repository object for sales associate role, what we will do, we will check permission tab, and for customer table we will give no access to my sales associate role. Okay. Steps for BA consumer role also. Okay, repeat the steps for BA consumer role as well. And okay, just see this. So for sales associate role, AlanZip is the member of sales associate role, right? For all the sales associate role people, I don't want to display one record, one table. So for that, what you can do, check this out, go to permissions, go to object permissions, add an object here, go for customer table, select it, give no access for this table.
Only that can be.
They cannot even see this table.
See this table.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. And click OK. And for BA consumer role also do the same thing. So what we are doing? For BA consumer role as well as sales associate role, I gave this as restricted. So just close this, check in the changes, check consistency, it will be consistent. Just close this, go to your application, login with WebLogic and reload server metadata. I am making the changes in online mode, right? Reload server metadata. Sign out of this, login with AlanZip user. Just go to new analysis, supplier sales. So are you able to see customer here? You are not able to see customer. Reason being, just check the application rules for this. I didn't restrict anything with BI author. Point number one. Point number two, for both for BI consumer and sales associate, I restricted it. But still he belongs to BI author. He should, but I didn't give any permission, right? So what is there for BI author? A default permission. Whereas for BI consumer and sales associate, I gave explicit permission. That means other than default, I gave it as explicitly no access. So the thing is, if you have multiple application roles for a particular user, and if you are giving something explicitly, that explicit permission will be overridden with the default one. Priority is for the explicit one. Okay, we will see all those points. Cancel this. Now, log in with JoesClothes and just check it. Okay. Okay, for him also just check the table whether it is available or not. It is not available. Just check the explanation. Is a member of sales manager role and sales supervisor role application roles, which are members of sales associate role. When you restrict access to associate role, the permissions are carried out to other roles also. Okay, fine. Now, set permissions to give members of sales supervisor role explicit access to the customer table. So I want all the, even though sales associate role it is restricted, I want sales supervisor role to have this table present. So what I will do, go to your sign out of this now, go to your RPD, go to manage identity, go to application roles. You have sales supervisor role. Double click on this, check out the object, go to permissions. So for customer table, give read access explicitly. I give read, just click OK, check out, click OK. So checking the changes and what is the step you have to do? Reload metadata. Because you are making the changes online, right? You have to do that, okay?
Now we have
login back with JoesClothes.
Now we can read the data, but we can't read it.
Reading is enough for us. Now you see customer table. So this is object level permission. What I am doing? Restricting for a particular application role to view a particular RPD object. Right? Based on the application roles. Now, this guy JoesClothes has even sales associate role also. In sales associate role, I restricted it. But for sales supervisor role, I enabled it. So there is a conflict. So for you belongs to two groups. For group A, I am restricting. For group B, I am giving the permission. And you belong to both the groups as a manager or supervisor. In this scenario, so what OBA does is the permission that is least restrictive will be preceded. Okay, so if something has given read access, that will be taken. If something is giving no access, instead of that it will go for read access. If you have conflicting permissions, the least conflicting permission, the least restrictive permission will be proceeded with the most restrictive permission. Okay, so most restrictive permission is no access, least restrictive is read access. So take read access like that. Just a second, guys. Hello. So the permission or the application role with least restrictive permission will be overridden by the permission with the role or the permission with most restrictive. Okay. So next we will see. So for sales supervisor role, I am giving real sales associate no access, BA consumer no access. So you can just check customer table is present. Okay. Next, for sales manager role also you can give no access. Okay. So even if you give sales manager no access, he will still be able to see data, because for sales supervisor role you gave a explicit access, right?
Like.
Fine. So this is object level security. So whatever you are doing is for object level security. Even go for customer table and you can check permissions for this table also. General permissions. You see that for BA administrator, all the default permissions are there. But for BA consumer, I give no access. For sales associate role, I give no access. And for sales supervisor role, I am giving read access. And for sales manager role, you can give no access. Okay, click OK. Checking the changes, still this will work. Okay, sign out, and if you sign in back with WebLogic, yeah, just go with reload server metadata. New analysis, still you should be able to see your customer table, because for one role the same thing, one role I give in, one role giving no access, does not matter actually. You will be still able to see the permission with the least restriction, so you will be able to see read. But if it is default and one more is manually given, for default it is just default, for sales supervisor, for manager if you are giving no access, it goes with no access. Yeah, so default will not be considered. Like that. Fine. Okay, this is done. Now next let us see how to set a row level security. That means if he is BA manager, he should able to see different data. If he is a normal developer, he should be able to see different data based on filters. Or if he belongs to one region, he should be able to see different data. If he belongs to one more region, he should be able to see different data. Like that. Now what I am doing, for sales supervisor role, I am giving this filter on my presentation table customer. Okay, so what I will do, go with this, go to manage identity application roles. For sales supervisor role, go to permission. There is something called data filters. Okay. Just click on this, and customer table I want to give this in the data filter equal to Betty New Year or something. You can just give this. Okay, so I give is equal to Joe Screws or Alan Z for Betty New Year. I want to filter this. Okay, just click OK. What is the issue with this? Okay, fine. Yes, just click OK. Check in the changes. Observe the query. Just sign out of this. Login back with WebLogic. So this is how you implement your data security, giving the permissions with respect to an organization or something like that. Okay. Now, reload files and metadata. Just go back to your application, login with Joe Screws, because he belongs to sales supervisor role, right? And we give data filters for sales supervisor. So just go for dashboards, sorry, new analysis, supplier sales. First, just go with product, specific and fact sales dollars. So just check how many records you get. So you should get, I think there are 196 product or something. So just get everything. You have 181. Just go here and for this, if you want to check query, where should you check it? Go to input query log and just check it. And I think I didn't enable logging for this day. So what to do? Go for BI administration, manage identity for users. Set online. So set the log level as 2 for these two guys, Joe Cruz and Alan Ziff. Login back with your WebLogic. Reload files and metadata. Okay. Now just sign out of this. Login back with your Joe Spruce. Just make new analysis and go for product, specific, fact sales, dollars, results. Let's check here. I have 181. Fine. Just go to your criteria. Just sign out of this and we'll check for query. Login back with your WebLogic. With respect to WebLogic, I don't have anything. So check in the query log. Go to computer. Go to my computer. E middleware. Instances one. BI formation. Diagnostics logs, BI server, NQ query log. So with respect to Joe's proof, you did that. Okay. So you don't have any filter with respect to customer here because you didn't include any customer related table. Just go here, login back with your Joe's proof. So I just wanted to show you that if it includes customer table, your data filters will get applied because you are making filters on the customer table. Okay, so go with new. Because see here if you go here, manage identity, application role, sales supervisor role, you made it for customer table. Suppose say for supplier sales, and if you want to add, right, on the business model layer, in the logical layer also you can add, but on a specific table you have to add. Okay, always. Right? So like that. Now do one thing. Go to new analysis. Same thing again. Pack sales, dollars, product, specific, and customer, customer name. Click on results. Who is this user? Just two only, right?
Yeah.
And you, customer, sales representative. Yeah, see here. So always you will be able to see Joe's Cruise, Betinier and Aranzif, nothing else. And just check, I didn't give any filter, right? Just check your query here. Close your query and check back your query. So here you can see that T, yeah, sales rep in Aranzif, Betinier and Joe's Cruise. So this is how, with respect to a particular application role, your query results will get filtered because I gave it in the query filter. The same way for any application role. Which one? Yeah, yeah, this we gave it in the filter, right, for application role. So the same thing will apply. Suppose say if you are dividing work, if you have application roles like North region customers and you have one more application of South region customers. For North region, you can give, if anything, like customer is equal, customer region is equal to North. So by default, they will be only able to see North data. That filter will automatically get updated. So that is how you go for data level security. Okay. Fine. Now, so this is done. Next, what you want, setting query limits and timing restrictions. This is of not maximum, very great use, but what you can see here, there is something called manage identity. Go again here. You can even set, so if the query is returning more than 5 rows and all, if you want to restrict it, you can even restrict it. Go to sales supervisor role, go to permissions, go to query limits, and as of now, your database, on each database, you can restrict it. So as of now, maximum rows is ignored, right? You can enable this, and maximum rows is just 5. Okay, I want only maximum rows from this database for this application role to be displayed. Right? And the max time ignore, and there is something called restriction time. So suppose on a particular day, now what is today?
Today is Friday.
Friday. So Friday at some time, if I want to restrict this, I can even do that. Okay, I'm restricting it. Click OK. Sign out and sign in back with WebLogic. Permissions you have to study a little bit because slowly you will understand. No issues. Issue SQL. Okay. Even purge cache also. Okay, sign out and sign in back with your Joseph. Because he is a sales supervisor, we will just see. We applied something like. Okay, so make a new analysis. And with respect to customer, I mean, the query for user Joe's Cruise exceeded the maximum query governing rows 5 from the database. Please have your system administrator look. Okay, I cannot, I gave restriction as 5. I cannot have that. So filter is in top 5 or something like that. So first 5 customer I will display. 5 will come. If I give 6, it won't come. Okay, and one more query restrictions I gave, right? Manage identity.
So for the timing.
Yeah. restrict.
Get this time. It's too okay.
Now, what is this time exactly here for me? Now, for us, 8:45, but I want to check the system time. Yeah. Eight 44 a.m. Same time it is giving, right? Go to criteria. Generally, it will give ORCL, ODBC error again. Okay, I don't know why it's not picking up. No issues. Okay. ODBC, the timing, we cannot make any queries till this point of time. So this gives the error message. Okay. So you can restrict any of your values or results by using giving various permissions with respect to your application roles and all the users which are present in that application role. You can even see that message, like associate role, if I give something, right? So you can see all the list of groups or people that are affected. So if I change some permissions for this, these are the people who are going to affect, like this. So you can even check all these permission roles, everything. Suppose say for sales manager role, if I do that, only Joe Screws and is member of sales associate role. Sales manager role is a member of sales associate role, right? So even you can see that whatever sales associate role has, everything will be present for sales manager role also, like. Okay, for sales supervisor role also you will have same thing. And now we will remove all the permissions that are done. Give it back as one back or something. Ignore. Okay. Okay, and one more is sales supervisor role permissions. Give data filter site. So remove this. Object permissions also. Cancel. For sales manager role, did we do something? Data filters. Very limits nothing. Sales associate role permissions. Data filters nothing. Object permissions. Okay. For customer, just check permissions. So for BI consumer, can give default. So all default I get. Okay. Check in the changes and just save it. Okay. Now logging back with your web login. just reload all the things, and all the permission restrictions would have gone off. Okay. So even if you log in with Alliance, if no, you should be able to see your customer table, right? So your customer table will be there because I removed all the restrictions and all the tables and everything. So there should not be any issue. So this is how you can work with your application roles, users and groups and play around with your security part for restricting the various objects from your users and application roles. Okay. So next chapter we have cache management and usage tracking. I think we have usage tracking also. So this we will see tomorrow. Cache management. So tomorrow we'll end my RPD part. So these are the last topics, last few topics that are left out. And usage tracking. Yeah, basic topics, very minor topics. Okay, you guys will understand easily. So tomorrow we will see. Fine. So any other questions?
Yeah, Pratap.